Then I'm in the desert. It appears to be in the Middle East somewhere. For some reason, I'm led to believe it's Iran, pre-Ayatollah. I'm at a very swank, very ostentatious country club. I'm swimming in a diving pool. My father and brother are there. I'm wearing a bikini, but lose the top in the pool. I get very self-conscious and embarrassed and ask my brother to dive under and get it, as I see it lying on the bottom. He tries, but it's too late. It's gone down the drain. Then I get all tangled up in a window frame that was floating in the pool, and I almost drown. I'm pulled from the pool. Then many servants surround the pool, which is now empty. They're dressed in ornate blue and gold uniforms and carry buckets of champagne. It is explained to me that this is a ritual execution. The pool will be filled with champagne, and the condemned man is to be thrown into it and shot or beheaded or dismembered or something. But it was something horrible because I know that I didn't want to watch it. I was horrified that all these dignitaries and Arab sheikhs sitting around the pool wanted to see this. I covered myself in a blanket and started to run. I climbed over and through a wooden catwalk, dodging or rather jumping over chocolate cakes that lie every 3 feet or so. People couldn't understand why I was trying to escape. I grabbed a dish towel and got outside. I put the towel on my head and saw my reflection. I thought I looked very biblical, like the Virgin Mary. And I was just about out of the gates and into the desert ahead of me when I was stopped by a very large, burly Armenian. He demanded to know where I was going. I'm going to live in the caves, in the desert, and get away from this disgusting display of savagery, I said. He wasn't going to let me do that and proceeded to guide me back to the country club, all the while telling me that he'd competed in the Arkansas Olympics. As we walked towards the club, I looked over my shoulder and I saw the desert and the mountains behind it, bathed in golden sunlight. I thought to myself, I have to get there somehow.
And I cried myself to sleep that night. I woke up the next morning, I had a big pain in my chest. I said, Daddy, Mama, come out quick! They ran in, what's wrong? Oh, my chest hurts so bad! They said, will you stay home from Christian school today, and you'll be okay. I said, all right. I stayed home, and as the day went on, the worse I got. Finally, they called a Christian doctor in, and he examined me. Marky, oh, it's so bad. Marky.
Oh, yes, sir.
Are you ready to go see Jesus?